The Keller-Schmaltz-Garland line, 15 points in the last four games. The power play is red hot. And oh yeah, the return of the captain, Oliver Ekman-Larsson, as we are underway. And now the Blues and David Perron holding onto it to the front, just sent wide. Now back out high as Mike Hoffman, one of the two-point men. He'll play it down low and back out high for Falk. Falk's got it, unloads, he scores! Power play goal for the Blues. And it's a 1-0 St. Louis lead.
For the St. Louis Blues, that's an understatement, but you know they've made some adjustments. They've had some practice time getting ready for this game, and it's all about just getting that puck to the middle of the ice. Perron feeds Falk, and there's the big shot. Falk lets it go.
And they'll bring it right back. Keller looking around. Keller, nice move to the front. A stop by Bennington. Oh, what a move by Clayton.
How dirty was that? That's absolutely sick. Yeah, for old twinkle toes, Clayton Keller. Look at the dirty toe drag there on Falk. The flyby. Absolutely.
Drops it. Garland out high. Garland to the front for Schmaltz. And now Garland gets it back. Goligoski, a little wrist shot is on, and a stop by Bennington.
Oh, what a shift for Goligoski, jumping up in the attack. Rush, middle of your screen, jumps, goes right through the middle, then he pops out, left of your screen now. And he's going to end up getting this puck, firing it off.
And Colton Parayko will bring it along. He's got to change defensively right at the end of the power play as O'Reilly brings it in. And Parayko with a shot, stop, rebound, side of the net, they put it home.
That's how you get a C on your jersey. The movement goes to the net, off the skate, and he's not done. He hangs around. He's hacking and whacking at that puck.
I think that went under the net, Tyson.
Yeah, I could be right. It looked like a real tough angle off the skate. Oh, yeah, I think you're right.
No, that's not going to count. No, I think it went under.
I need a better look here.
I think it went under. I think the net was elevated, and it went, as this one will be played away, and the Coyotes will get it out as it's sent all the way back down. Racing is Kraus. He hit the post.
Another post for Kraus. What else is new?
And that was a set play.
Here's a look at it. He zips that puck right off the boards, and that's a streaking Lawson Kraus. And here's another angle of it. Bank pass. Oncoming Kraus.
Coyotes were 50% in the faceoff circle. That's starting to trend in the right direction a little bit. And Kraus and Fisher each with three hits in the opening 20. It's Keller off the right wing side. And he sent it right to Colton Parayko. And the Blues will counter. They're back in. Across, Falk with a shot. Pen save, Kemper. Plays it in behind the net and back out high. Osterling. Kicked it along. Coyotes got something cooking in the offensive third. Out high, shot. Osterley, they score! It's in!
Well, how about that movement by the Coyotes? Zipping that puck around, and I'm not sure how or who ended up putting this puck in the back of the net. Larsson, his first as a Coyote, and the fourth line's first goal of the season. Hayden takes it around the horn. He brings Falk right up top. Oh, yeah. That's Larsson on the rebound. Christian Fisher, I think, maybe redirects that right onto the stick of Larsson, and he whacks it.
And then didn't get the glory or the spotlight and just decided to jump on Dallas Drake anyways. It's a long story.
And that one off the pipe. Thanks for that, Todd, as Falk just hit one off the pipe. Batted away, so there certainly is history between these two clubs.
Of zone time, Falk, who can rip it, throws it at the net. Kemper gets a piece, and so does the post.
Now Connor Garland trying to set it up along the near boards. He's stripped of the puck, kept by Chychrun. Here's a look, Schmaltz curls to the front, a shot, rebound, they can't put it home. Oh, it was right there for Schmaltz. A real good effort there because he was beaten on the play, but he was able to get the puck right back in. And a chance now into the corner. Connor Garland trying to curl and drag, and he scores! It gets by Bennington! Connor Garland is at it again!
Kraus to shoot it right there. He does it. He dishes it off. And Connor Garland gets his pocket pick, and he sticks with it. He gets knocked down, and he still gets the shot off. Somehow, some way, there's Shen, knocks them down, and that puck just beats Bennington. Terrible goal to give up. just squeaks over the pack. Well, here's the puck. Labushkin enters the zone, and oh yeah, that's offside.
The official.
After review, the call on the ice is overturned. We got offside. The clock go back at 1:21.
Scooped up momentarily by Dvorak, and he sends it in. Coyotes looking to change here. Into the corner it goes. Pitlick out high. Schmaltz with a chance in front. It's Lawson Kraus, and he can't get it past Binnington. And again, Lawson Kraus all over it, Tyson.
Can't buy one. Lawson Kraus pass right in there. Gets it, feathers it to Kraus. He knows. That's anticipation. And awareness, offensive awareness by Nick Schmaltz to recognize Kraus was all alone in front. There's the redirection. And Binnington just gets a toe on it. That left pad out of nowhere.
Sanford's working it back out high. Watch there. And the Blues set it up. Kyrou down low. And Krugie hit the pipe. Torrey Krug put one off the pipe as it goes into the corner now. Are the Blues to set it up? Vince Dunn. And now Dunn out high. Krug unloads. He hit the outside. I thought that might have been in, but evidently it did not go in.
Binnington. And then here's the shot. Howitzer redirected both posts. You take a look at Darcy Kuemper trying to look around Schwartz.
That's their best power play. They've had over a minute 30 of offensive zone time here on this man advantage.
More pipes than Home Depot.
Out of the box is Larson, bringing it in is Pitlick. He shoots, getting a piece was Binnington, and a rebound ends up in behind the net. And it'll be played along back through center ice. Perron couldn't control, goes all the way back. No icing here. As the Blues back to get it, Jordan Kyrou has it.
Yeah, good wheels there by Kyrou.
And now Kyrou to the front, a chance, and they score, and it's Falk, and it's his second of the game. Falk trailing the play, and he's given the Blues a 2-1 lead.
Right there, and then he finds Falk right through the middle of the ice. Where are the Coyotes? There's the pass. That's a defenseman. You're a winger. That is your guy. Whether he came off the bench or not, it doesn't matter. You have to know.
Coyotes look to get it set up. Empty net. Extra attacker is out. Schmaltz, he's got it. He shoots a stop and a rebound off the pipe, I believe. That might have been a stick clanging off the pipe as well.
And here was the chance. Schmaltz takes it, fires it. The rebound. Clayton Keller gets it. And I think Binnington gets a right pad on that one. Another look from a high angle.
Oh. Falk right in the middle of it. And Falk will flip one right back to center. Shen to Barbashev. And that's going to do it.
The side of the net, and then there's the empty netter. Good battle factor by the Blues.
A little unselfish play there by Shen to look for O'Reilly. He could have shot that in the empty net himself.
Barbashev trying to get it out. Shen's going to bring it the other way, and the Blues are going to get their second empty net goal here. So it's a 4-1 game.
Well, there it is. Off a faceoff, and Connor Garland almost gets him at the end.
And now Dunn will bring it along back through center for Mackenzie McEachran. They'll dump it in, and the St. Louis Blues in game five of this historic 7 in a row win it by the score 4-1.